Getting the classic analog look with digital cameras is desired not only because we are all nostalgic, but by playing with the film look we learn a bit about color and black and white film qualities like the film grain, halation and bloom effects. Those characteristics give film a very unique look and visual experience, especially comparing to digital files. So modern digital cameras can produce ultra-sharp images with a very standard look to them, and sometimes it misses a little bit of character. So today I'm gonna be testing the Dehancer Film Emulation plugin and see if I can recreate the film look on a digital file. So Dehancer Film can be used with Adobe Photoshop, Adobe Lightroom and Capture One. I'm gonna be using Adobe Lightroom. So Dehancer has asked me to test their plugin, but this is not a paid review, so I'm gonna be giving my honest opinion. Okay, so I have Adobe Lightroom opened here and I have my first image. But before bringing this to the Dehancer, what I'm gonna do here is flatten this image a little bit so I can have a larger dynamic range to apply all the settings in the Dehancer Film Emulation. So what I'm gonna do here, and that's the recommendation, is to reduce the exposure. I'm gonna go to -1 and reduce the contrast -40 and then the blacks to +60. Okay, so now I'm ready to open the Dehancer plugin. And these are the settings that Dehancer uses. So the file format will be TIFF. It works on a color space of sRGB. And it's 16 bits. You can choose the resolution if you like it, but it's good to keep 300. Now, with Dehancer opened, I have on my left side all the profiles and presets. There are more than 60 to choose from. You can pick any one you like. It's a good starting point, but then you can make all the adjustments you want on the right side menu here. And there's a lot to work with. On the top left panel, you can collapse your screen. You can go to the preferences. You can restore last used settings, reset all settings to the default. On the top right panel, you can see your image a little bit larger, 100%, and you can see the before and after your edits. Okay, so I have this beautiful backlit photograph, and I'm gonna apply the profile Fujicolor Pro 400H. We can see the before and after, and then I'm gonna make some adjustments with the print and the color head. So the print is really gonna work with the tonal range, and the color head, it's gonna add some more color control to the photograph. So once I'm here, I'm gonna change this maybe to the gloss paper, and the color head, I'm gonna bring the magentas and the yellow. Then the film grain, I think it looks good as it is. I'm not gonna change anything, and I'm gonna work with the halation. And you can see this orange super strong light around all the edges where there's a lot of highlights and shadows. So these areas of contrast are super strong and create the halation that you see on film, and you miss that in digital photography. Okay, let's try this nighttime scene. I have this gas station that was super nice lit, but I wanted to look a little bit more like film. So I'm gonna apply the CineSteel 800T because it's a gas station, and if you shoot film, you know very well that's the one to use. Then I'm gonna go to the color head, and that's where I'm gonna do most of the changes on a color. So I'm gonna apply a little bit more of yellow and a little bit more of green. Okay, let's see the difference before and after. Pretty nice. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to the halation. I'm gonna increase the source and I'm gonna amplify the halation. So, okay, let's see the difference before and after. And if you go to 100%, you can see the highlights here and especially here. So just to increase the effect of the glowy effect. So I'm gonna check the bloom, amplify a little bit on the source, and let's see the before and after. And that's all I'm gonna do with this image. So let's see, a little bit smaller, the before and the after. Okay, going to the coast of Ireland now, I'm gonna choose the Fujichrome Velvia 50. You can see the before and after. And I'm gonna go to the print and change the glossy paper to 2383 print film. and then I'm going to scroll down a little bit, and the color head, I'm going to make the image a little bit more magenta and more to the blue, a little bit more red. Okay, that's our before and after. It's pretty close to what I was seeing at the day. And all I have to do now is apply the grain, and I'm gonna see this a little bit larger. We can see the sky here before and after. And our subjects before and after. The whole photograph looks a lot nicer now. Okay, for this photograph, I want to do something pretty quick. Just one click. I'm not gonna use any of the adjustments on the right panels here. So I'm just gonna use one of the presets, which is basically the profile with some of these adjustments already included in them. So you can see here the Dehancer team on the top left. And here we have all the presets that we can use. So I'm just gonna check the preview here. I can see the before and after. And I already selected one that I like, which is the Fuji Reala, that I think it works pretty well for this photograph. All right, so this next photograph was taken in Brazil in the South Coast, and all I want to do here is to add a little bit of a warm tone and also the grain. So I'm gonna choose my favorite profile, which I already selected here, which is the Kodak Chrome 64. And I can see, click on the preview here, the before and after. And it's pretty much what I wanted to do here. Now, the next thing is just to add the grain. So I think there's a lot of grain here. When I go full size, I can see it's a little bit too much. So I'm gonna just reduce the amount, go halfway. Okay, let's see before and after. That's my original photograph, that's now. So it's really the perfect settings for this photograph. So I haven't used all the tools in the adjustment panel area because it's so detailed, that's actually crazy. There's an amount of settings and slides that you can play with that's just gonna take a while to master all of them. For example, the grain section has specific adjustments for shadow, highlights, and midtones. And you can also play with the color film grain, which is pretty unique. So I have just scratched the surface, and I think it will take a long time to play with all the settings that they offer. You can really tell that the developers put a lot of thought and research to create these profiles. They really consider all the tools you have in a real darkroom, and they really apply that to the digital software. So my only criticism is for the size of the profiles and preset thumbnails in the section area. Sometimes you can't really see the difference between the settings and the color applied to each of them. They could be a little bit bigger, but this is pretty minor. So I think overall, this is the best plugin for photography that I ever used. And if you like the film look, the Dehancer Film Emulation is a no-brainer. If you like it and you want to try the plugin, please use the code in the description to get 10% off. Please let me know what you think about the results that I got from these images, and I see you very soon.